Unveil your mastery, a journey of total transformation. Remember who you truly are. Today we are talking about the topic Clear Your Genetic Blocks and Ancestry Around Money. Hi Elke, how are you?
Hi Monica, I'm fine. How are you doing?
Yes, I'm always fine again when I'm talking with you.
That's great. And hi everyone, and I hope you are doing fine as well. And today's theme is about your genetic blocks and ancestry around money. And some, of course, will ask themselves what this is all about.
Yes,
and
what it's all about. What is a genetic block and ancestry tell?
See, Monica is asking herself as well. So.
I want to know what I'm talking about.
That's always good, and that's why we are having those conversations. So this week's track, it's week 7 of our series, and should, if you are a member, should be in your inbox by now, along with a symbol and the PDF with the exercise. And really, this week the track will really clear and remove all those genetics and blocks that have been ingrained in your DNA and in your subconscious about family patterns around money. Meaning everyone has in their family, there have been certain patterns that just have been repeated by their parents, their grandparents, their great-grandparents, and they have gone through centuries. Most of the families have been poor, and there is a certain pattern that revolves around money, how they handle money, what the beliefs they have around money. And if it's gone through a certain time, it really is embedded in the genetics. It's the same with health issues. So if there are certain diseases that are running in the family for a longer time, so it will be in your DNA. And mm-hmm. and this recording will tackle those encodements and the belief systems and help you remove them. But for you, it is required to really become conscious about what's happening here, so it can really be released and removed.
Mm-hmm. Yes, can I imagine? Yes, you explained it very well with this with these diseases. I think nearly everyone knows somebody, or perhaps himself is. Has someone who tells you he has he's afraid to get cancer because it's in the family?
Yeah, well, and, most people, let's say your father has had a bad hip and they had their hip replaced. So most people start to worry if they get that too. Or if your mom had breast cancer and you are thinking, oh my God, it's already you are thinking, so it's in your belief that you are that this might happen to you because it runs in the family. And it's the same with patterns around money. So it's really the same. There is no difference.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And when you believe in it, it's sure that it will come, because when you believe you get cancer, you will. It's nearly 10% that you. That you will get cancer.
Of course, the more you fear something, the more you really put it out that it comes in, because the universe doesn't know the difference. It's really, as you are thinking about it all the time, it comes more and more into your reality, right? And also, even if you don't think about it, but it's in your subconscious, it's the same, but there is still always that fear, I might get it as well because it runs in the family.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And this is what it is. And mm-hmm. really to become free of this is the purpose of this recording. And also, I mean, the thing is, we are not subject to our genetics and our subconscious beliefs. We can release that. And to really become conscious about what is running in your family. So it ties neatly with into this week's exercise we mm-hmm. have prepared for you.
Yes.
Oh, yes, Monica,
it
you
it goes around. No, I only wanted to say that the first step to release these patterns is to get conscious about it. And yes, the exercise is about that, to become conscious. No?
Yes. Yes. So when you just look into your family history, just like you would look into my father had this and this illness, and my mother had this, and my grandmother had this, and just look at it. And the same you do do with money, with patterns around money. So what's there are certain patterns your parents have with money. So there are certain sayings they have. So let's say I had a grandfather that always said bread is hard to earn. So that's why we don't, he didn't like to eat bread, right? Because mm-hmm. that's just a saying that was going on in Germany because of the war. And they took it over. And so they bought and ate everything in except bread, so to speak. So there's always a certain pattern. They don't buy this, or they don't even sometimes if they have the money, they don't buy it because it runs in their family that you are poor and you just don't mm-hmm. want to spend the money because because money is really hard to come by, so you better keep it. If you mm-hmm. spend it, you might run out of money again, right? Yeah. So and this is really this pattern. There's so many that come out of poor families, and they really work hard and earn a lot of money and don't spend anything. And then when they die, they have hundreds and thousands of dollars or even more, millions, and they never really spend it and enjoyed their abundance. Mm-hmm. Right, and this is because in their family was always poor, and that's why they were afraid to spend it. And these are the patterns. So, is there a reason why you are afraid to spend money or to indulge into something? Or where does it come from? Mm-hmm. Ask yourself, where does it come from that I really, let's say, I really have enough money to buy myself an ice cream, but because it costs $3 or whatever, and this is just some belief pattern says this is too much to pay for an ice cream, yes. I'm not buying it, although I have the money, right? It would be an indulgement, and that's not, it's just... Yeah, so that's really a family pattern. Instead of enjoying the ice cream, if you really enjoy it and not just buy it because you want to fill some emptiness within yourself, where we come back to last week's theme.
Yes.
So really, that's the thing. So, I mean, if I don't have the money, of course, then... What holds me back from letting this abundance in? If there's a pattern of poverty, that's a poverty consciousness that's ingrained in your family. So that's in your DNA, and it really blocks you from having abundance. And freeing yourself from these ancestral blocks and codes is the first step to letting the abundance in, and then stopping to repeat those patterns and have that belief that money is scarce and there is not enough for everyone and all those things. If you believe there is not enough for everyone, and especially for you, of course there won't be enough for you.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's you make your truth yourself. You create your own universe, so
yeah,
to say.
You create your own reality. It really is true. So
yes.
If there is a belief that there is not enough for you, of course there never will be enough. And this is what this week's recording helps removing. But the real crucial part as well is that you are become conscious about what you are doing and what is holding you back. So really, every week it's really important that the recording is important. That's why we are doing both. The recording is important because it makes it easier, a lot easier. And the second, the conversation, the explanation and the exercise makes it easier for you to become conscious and turn those patterns around and release them.
And do not repeat them again.
Exactly. And then really find your own truth, your own enjoyment, and embody your own self, your true self. And not what you have been taught and what runs in your family and all those beliefs and those patterns that you are repeating.
Yes.
And most
so,
people unconsciously really do it because, well, it has been done this way for eons, so why they never think about it. And this is really the purpose of this, that you get aware that it doesn't
you don't
have
quest-
to be this way.
You don't question it simply, no. It's done like it's done, and so you don't question it normally.
Very many people don't question things. And it's very important to question things.
Yes.
This is where you start to wake up and to really start to find your own truth. And Monica and I are trying to help you to get to this truth a little quicker than you would on your own. And we hope we are somewhat accomplishing this and you get something out of our ramblings.
Yes.
And it would be, as I said before, it's really our heart's desire to make it easier for everyone and anyone. And to work to make this world the true Eden that it is, because the more people get aware of that they don't have to, that it doesn't have to be the way it was and live according to their own truth, the more, the Eden it becomes.
The more easy the whole planet becomes.
The more easy life becomes, and the more fun, and the more of a playground it really will be, and the Eden it was created to be. Yes.
Yes. Something I wanted to say is also that it sometimes it takes longer than 1 week until a recording should be finished. Could you explain it? Please, for me. No, not for me, but how to use the recordings in this site.
So our recommendation was just because every week, of course, we publish a new recording, so that you listen to it for 10 days and then take the next one and listen to that for 10 days. So when the first one is finished after 10 days, and you have the second one, and then so always for 10 days. But of course, everyone is unique. So, and some have more baggage in one certain area and more gunk there, more density. Of course, sometimes you will feel that you need more time for a certain area for recording than those 10 days. So, just go with it. There will be a feeling, there will be an inner voice. You will just know it. So if you really have the calling to listen to it longer, or let's say after 2 months you have the feeling you should go back to a certain recording, do it and then listen to it as long as you feel it's appropriate. So listen to your own guidance, to your own inner voice, and just play with it. So this way you are connecting with your inner guidance, and then find out what is right for you, because not everyone is different. So you have your own unique journey to go on, or to that you have, and just follow this guidance, and so more and more you will develop your own way and your own connection to your higher self, to your guidance, and feel this connection. It's just it comes automatically. It's hard to explain. That's why I'm looking for words. So this is follow your inner connection. Monica, you told me sometimes you listen to a recording for a certain time, and then you feel it doesn't give you anything anymore, and then you stop listening. And if you could explain a little bit more of your experience in this area.
Yes, I love to hear these recordings, but at a certain point it becomes it tells nothing more. It's just music for me, and then I know it's time to stop it and to try another recording or don't matter. But what also is happening sometimes is that later on, I think, oh, let's look about this recording, this old one, and I listen to it again, and it's like, yes, it's speaking to me again. It's
Exactly. So basically, I mean, some people, they don't feel anything, right? But if there's an inner voice that tells you should listen to the recording, then it is there for a reason. So listen to it for the initial days, and then when you just have the thought, I should go back to this recording, even if you don't feel anything with the recordings, it's still happening. So Monica feels it like this. You might perceive it in a different way, in a similar way. So everyone perceives it differently. There is no right or wrong way. So, but for most people, it will be like Monica's experience. But don't be worried if you don't feel anything, right? So it's still working. If you are becoming conscious about what you are doing and what's going on, and not, I would say, mindlessly repeat the patterns you have been taught and the conditioning that you have gone through, and
Yes.
that really is it.
I know people who are telling me that they don't feel anything, but it works either. I see it.
It works either way. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, just go with your own guidance. If there's a thought or a feeling that you should go back to a certain recording, it is there for a reason.
Yes, that's it. Okay, next week we are talking about clearing mental fog around money. Another interesting topic, Elke.
Awesome. Thank
I'm
you,
looking
Monica,
forward.
that you will enlighten us about this aspect of ourselves, and I look forward to your explanation.
Yes. Okay. I'll
It
do my
was
best.
awesome to talk to you again, and we are so happy that you guys were here to listen to us, and we hope to see you, hear you, whatever, next week, and enjoy your week and have lots and lots of fun.
That's
And
it.
have fun playing with the exercise.
Yes.
Love you
Bye.
guys. Bye.